Good morning, St. John, St. Paul Collaborative. Welcome. Welcome to this, our first ever Mass in this new virtual world. We welcome you to the fourth Sunday of Lent. We just like to point out there are some links that are underneath this video. Click on them. The worship aid is available to you there, so you can sing along with all of the music, follow along with the readings to the Mass. We welcome you warmly. I hope that this is a blessing to your Sunday morning. I hope you're safe and well. We are definitely praying with you.
Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Good morning, everyone. It's so hard for us to be apart, and this is our attempt at least connecting virtually, so that we can be together, for we are one in Christ. Our hearts and prayers go out to all of you, and pray prayers for your safety and health, and also that you would really feel a strong sense of God's presence, God's peace, and God's love. I want to tell you who's here that you can't see. So we have a wonderful music group assembled. Kelly on vocals, Anne on piano, Katie on flute, and Luke on guitar and vocals. And of course, Father Walker here with me. Let's remember, as we open our hearts to God's love, just how much God loves us. As we open our hearts to the transformative power of God's love and mercy. Lord Jesus, you heal the sick. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you forgive our sins and failings. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are our healer and redeemer, bringing us new and everlasting life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
And may Almighty God have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who through your word reconcile the human race to yourself in a wonderful way, grant, we pray, that with prompt devotion and eager faith, the Christian people may hasten toward the solemn celebrations to come. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen.
A reading from the first book of Samuel. The Lord said to Samuel, "Fill your horn with oil and be on your way. I am sending you to Jesse of Bethlehem, for I have chosen my king from among his sons." As Jesse and his sons came to the sacrifice, Samuel looked at Eliab and thought, "Surely the Lord's anointed is here before him." But the Lord said to Samuel, "Do not judge from his appearance or from his lofty stature, because I have rejected him. Not as man sees does God see. Because man sees the appearance, but the Lord looks into the heart." In the same way, Jesse presented 7 sons before Samuel. But Samuel said to Jesse, "The Lord has not chosen any of these." Then Samuel asked Jesse, "Are these all the sons you have?" Jesse replied, "There is still the youngest who is tending the sheep." Samuel said to Jesse, "Send for him. We will not begin the sacrificial banquet until he arrives here." Jesse sent and had the young man brought to them. He was a ruddy, a youth handsome to behold, and making a splendid appearance. The Lord said, "There, anoint him, for this is the one." Then Samuel, with the horn of oil in hand, anointed David in the presence of his brothers. And from that day on, the Spirit of the Lord rushed upon David. The word of the Lord.
Praise be to God.
Shepherd me, O God, beyond my wants.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, you were once darkness, but now you are light in the Lord. Live as children of light, for light produces every kind of goodness and righteousness and truth. Try to learn what is pleasing to the Lord. Take no part in the fruitless works darkness. Rather expose them, for it is shameful even to mention the things done by them in secret. But everything exposed by the light becomes visible, for everything that becomes visible is light. Therefore it says, "Awake, O sleeper, and arise from the dead, and Christ will give you light." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
As Jesus passed by, he saw a man blind from birth. He spat on the ground and made clay with the saliva and smeared the clay on his eyes and said to him, "Go wash in the pool of Siloam," which means sent. So he went and washed and came back able to see. His neighbors and those who had seen him earlier as a beggar said, "Isn't this the one who used to sit and beg?" Some said, "It is." But others said, "No, he just looks like him." He said, "I am." They brought the one who was once blind to the Pharisees. Now Jesus had made clay and opened his eyes on a Sabbath. So then the Pharisees asked him also how he was able to see. He said to them, "He put clay on my eyes, and I washed, and now I can see." So some of the Pharisees said, "This man is not from God, because he does not keep the Sabbath." But others said, "How can a sinful man do such signs?" And there was division among them. So they said to the blind man again, "What do you have to say about him, since he opened your eyes?" He said, "He is a prophet." They answered and said to him, "You were born totally in sin, and are you trying to teach us?" Then they threw him out. When Jesus heard that they had thrown him out, he found him and said, "Do you believe in the Son of Man?" He answered and said, "Who is he, sir, that I may believe in him?" Jesus said to him, "You have seen him, and the one speaking with you is he." He said, "I do believe, Lord." And he worshiped him. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
We don't know his name. The scripture only describes him as a man who was born blind. We do know that by his encounter with Jesus, his life was completely changed. He had woken up that morning like any other morning, without hope, forced to do nothing but sit by the side of the road begging, hoping that people around him would take pity on him. But through Jesus' healing touch, his eyes were open for the first time. And what a sense of rejoicing there must have been that he finally could see how beautiful the world looked. And yet that was not the only healing that took place that day. Not only was the man healed of his physical blindness, but it was revealed to him through the eyes of faith who Jesus was who had healed him. He knew that he was looking at Jesus, and in looking at Jesus, was looking into the face of God. And with his life now centered in Jesus, he lived with purpose. He lived with meaning. For with Jesus at the center of his life, whatever was going on around him, he would always be at home. In these unprecedented days, in all of our living memories, we've all been grappling with strange feelings that we have a hard time describing. I was trying to remember whether there was ever a time in my life when the feelings that I'm having now in this time of social distancing and isolation, whether there was ever a time when I had similar feelings. The best way I can describe, or the feeling that I can relate this most directly to, is a feeling of homesickness. That longing for the familiar. That longing for what we know. That longing for what we love. And how difficult it has been to have that sense of well-being taken away from us. Of course, for very important public health reasons. I remember a time in my life when I truly was homesick. It was 1984, and I was a student studying abroad in the Soviet Union. I particularly remember the holidays, imagining on Thanksgiving Day my family gathered around, the familiar sights and smells and sounds, and my heart longed to be with them. My group at that time was traveling to the city of Kiev, the capital of Ukraine, and instead of eating turkey, we ate some form of Ukrainian meatloaf. Just didn't quite do it for me. And I was longing for home. Christmas Day, even worse. Our Russian friends had tried to make it nice for us and told us we were going to be having turkey. And I didn't understand why at 9 o'clock at night, I still didn't smell it cooking. And then it arrived. One tiny turkey leg for each person. And it was fried. So that didn't quite do it. Homesickness is that feeling of longing for what we know, for what we love. I was feeling that very acutely last Sunday. On a Sunday, I'm used to the excited sounds of squealing children running for their donuts after the 9 o'clock mass. That sense of coming together in community, that sense of belonging to each other, that sense of God's presence. And it's so hard not to have that. Let's face it too, I miss other things. I miss gathering with my friends in a restaurant and having a good time. And also, we've been planning so hard for all of these Lenten programs, which I would have been impossibly busy working at during this whole Lenten season. And suddenly, all of our programs have come to a crashing halt. But what is Lent supposed to be about, after all? Lent is a time when we let go of the things that aren't essential in our lives so that we can make more room for God. Is there a way that during this difficult time we can allow God to fill that place of longing within us? Sometimes when we're occupied by many things, we aren't aware of that longing only God can fill. So even in this difficult time, let's use it as the gift that it can be, to realize our dependence on God, and to realize that at every moment of our lives, God is with us. It seems almost ironic that we are celebrating today Laetare Sunday, or is it Gaudete? Anyway, it's one of those, and I didn't check my notes beforehand, but we're supposed to be rejoicing today, thus the pink vestment. But can we rejoice? We can. Because regardless of the external circumstances of our lives, when Jesus is alive within us, we have cause for rejoicing. We have cause for rejoicing because the one who never abandons us is with us. And Jesus living in us helps us to take our eyes off of ourselves and outward to others, to the most vulnerable among us, to the sick, to doing what we can, even under these difficult circumstances, to continue to serve those in need. That sense of homesickness is one that we may have for some time to come. But as we let Jesus fill it, let's remember that with him in our center, whatever is happening, we are always at home.
Friends, let's stand now and together profess our faith. I believe in one God, Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages. God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. And by the Holy Spirit, was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended to heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins.
and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead,
and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Lord God, even in our darkest hour, we know that you are the light of the world. Kindle in us your fire that produces light, goodness, and truth. As we turn our hearts to you, O Lord, dependent now in a very real way on the intercession of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, as we pray.
For the Church, that she would be a beacon of light in this time of grief and uncertainty, we pray in a particular way for those in Italy who are suffering such significant losses. May the Church be a source of strength and hope. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our collaborative, that despite our physical distance from one another, we would be connected by the power of the Holy Spirit and continue our Lenten journey with one another. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of our individual spiritual lives, may this time of retreat be one of profound growth. May we feel the love of Christ in a more intimate way as the noise of the world is silenced for a time. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who are spiritually blind and do not yet know the depth of God's love for them, may this time be one of awakening for them. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For every small business, parent struggling to work from home, student missing the end of their school year, child missing their daily routine, teacher missing their students, elderly, those who rely on social services for their basic needs, the homeless, the underemployed, those who have lost their jobs, and particularly those in the healthcare industry who are risking their own lives, their own health, to support the safety of our community. May God bless and protect us. May he make his face shine upon us, and may he grant us his peace. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who have died, we pray in a particular way at this Mass for all of those who have died from COVID-19. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, you open our eyes. Open them now to the reality of your true presence within each of us. We make our prayer through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen.
Saints and
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of his church.
We place before you with joy these offerings, which bring eternal remedy, O Lord, praying that what we may both faithfully revere them and present them to you as is fitting for the salvation of all the world, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to you.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. By the mystery of the Incarnation, he has led the human race that walked in darkness into the radiance of the faith, and has brought those born in slavery to ancient sin through the waters of regeneration to make them your adopted children. Therefore, all creatures of heaven and earth sing a new song in adoration, and we, with all the host of angels, cry out and without end, sending down your spirit upon them like a dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Sean, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, with St. John the Evangelist, with St. Paul, and all the saints who have pleased you through co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom,
the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Thank you.
Let us pray. O God, who enlighten everyone who comes into this world, illuminate our hearts, we pray, with the splendor of your grace, that we may always ponder what is worthy and pleasing to your majesty, and love you in all sincerity, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please bow your heads now and pray for God's blessing. Look upon those who call to you, O Lord, and sustain the weak. Give life by your unfailing light to those who walk in the shadow of death, and bring those rescued by your mercy from every evil to reach the highest good, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
Speak your mind.